What's up, everyone? So the other day, in this video, I said that there was no operating system for I2P like Tor has, and by that I meant like Tails and Unix, among others. The internet came back, though, and said,
"Don't ever tell me what I can't do, ever!"
So, I stand corrected. To be fair, though, the creator made the announcement about this operating system 4 days ago. I saw it today and immediately made a video about it. Like, I also bought a seedbox and created a torrent specifically for the operating system so that you, yes, you watching this video, can try it out and, you know, it won't take you an hour to download it, because when I downloaded it, you know, from the official site, it was super slow. And I was excited and I didn't want to wait. Now, if you don't want to actually use the torrent I made, I'm working on, you know, getting it up on a URL for you as a direct download. So that said, it'll be in the description for the seedbox. That said, if you are in a position to download and see the torrent, please do so, you know, so that we can share this with everyone. The seedbox is paid for a month. I figured that would be enough time to get people, you know, who can actually seed it in a position to do so. So first off, the name of the OS is Prestium. I think I pronounced that right. Kind of weird. Like, I Googled it to see if it like meant anything cool, like Kali Linux does. And this is what I got. Pretty lame. I was disappointed. That said, the name is the only thing that is lame about the OS. It does work, and I will show you the whole process of downloading it and running it. So, like, don't worry about that. It's in this video, but I saved it for last. I really wanted to give you the history of the OS, as, you know, the history is super short. So, before we continue, disclaimer. I know that this OS exists, and I have not, like, vetted the code or confirmed anything else beyond the fact that downloading it and running it does allow you to have a live I2P distro at hand, which is awesome because a lot of people are having issues with it. To me, that was good enough to act and to help spread this. Be sure to subscribe and like this video. Definitely helps to get stuff like this out. So the creator of this OS is on Reddit, and, you know, from his or her own statements on Reddit alone, no other social media. So without further ado, let me introduce them. So, yeah, I mean, did you think that was going to go like some other kind of way? Well, that creator's profile page on Reddit, here's like, you know, what you can expect to see on the official Reddit page for the distro. Yeah, not much, I know. That said, the developer seems to be pretty chill. He seemed to be highly responsive and, you know, not a dick. So that's cool. I had written him to like let him know that I was planning on doing this very video. And in response, here's what he had to say. "Hello, Sam. I'm absolutely excited and thankful that someone is actually interested enough to make a video about Prestium. I'm looking forward to watching it. Spreading awareness about this OS is, of course, vital for its success and to help people retain their privacy and allow them to easily access to the I2P network, as many people struggle getting onto it. When it comes to doing interviews, I always tell people that I want to stay private, anonymous for as long as possible until someone actually finds me. This is the reason why I decline every single voice/video interview. I would love to do it, but I really can't. We can do it through text interview, IRC, Reddit, if you would like to. If you have any specific questions you would like to ask, I'm open to this. Everyone is welcome on Prestium. So if it grows, that would be lovely. I appreciate everyone. Also, I've also checked your channel, and it seems you know a thing or two about cybersecurity and computers in general, which is perfect. Great videos. They're relaxing and easy to listen to. So you two keep up the amazing work. Again, thank you a lot. Opicaak. Cack. I have no idea how to pronounce your name, dude. I'm so sorry if I butchered it. So anyways, nice to have, you know, kind developers. Now, let's get to the main event. You know, why you clicked on this video to begin with. And let's take a look at this new OS in action. Okay, so first things first. Let's see. I'm in Windows, you know, please forgive me. You know, people are already yelling at me. I can already hear it. You know, so I'm going to go create a new virtual machine. I've already downloaded the .iso file. So I'm just going to name the virtual machine. And then we're going to select the ISO file that we downloaded. Select Linux, make sure it's 64-bit. Yeah, we're good. That's it, yeah. And now we're going to add another CPU, a little bit more memory. Just give it a little oomph. Well, I2P taking 3 years to start up now, do we? So, and we hit the start button. Let's get this baby going. That simple, right? I mean, it's super quick. And it was like, I don't know, 30 seconds or something. So now we see, boom, it's starting up. It boots up, you know, a lot quicker than I thought it would. I freaked out initially when I first started it. And you'll see that right here. It was a fail. I guess still it works, you know, fine. So here you type user. It was before the last edition, you had a password too, but this one doesn't have that. There's an EE version, and that's like the experimental version or whatever that, you know, you have root access in that one. This one doesn't have that. I don't need it. You know, I don't need to have root access for this video. We're just taking a tour on it to see how it works, if it works. So we see, I'm going to go ahead and change the display resolution because, and this is like, you know, I don't know. It's not good. This one, click that checkbox and boom, we see it get much bigger. Awesome. So now we can at least kind of see what we're doing. And we're going to open it up. I'm opening up both the web browser and the web console. Now we see that, you know, it says I2P control disabled, like all this stuff. It's like, oh, everything's disabled. So this web console wouldn't have opened up if I2P wasn't running. It's a good thing to know. Obviously, some of you have I2P experience. Sometimes, you know, it takes a little bit for stuff to load up. So just give it a little bit. And then, you know, on the left, we have our web browser. On the right, we have our web console. So I tried entering in DuckDuckGo. I had an issue with that. So I was like, hey, let me, you know, run services to see what services are running. And I didn't see I2P running. Excuse me. So this is a proxy for YouTube, which is interesting. I love the fact that that actually exists in I2P. So like we see it loads, right? So it does load. And then like I do something and I try searching, you know, the best channel on YouTube. And yeah, it just totally fails. And it's like, screw you, dude. Like, you see, like total fail. So yeah, it's a bad hit. I'm going to try a different site. And it's I2P, so it's going to take a little bit. You know, it connects. Sometimes it fails. And like when it fails, like it's weird. So I'm definitely an I2P noob too. I'm learning all this with you guys. But like, you know, boom, we see right here, boom, Invisible Internet Project, which is obviously I2P's website. And that's you can see the .I2P. So that's awesome. Let's try another one. I was really excited for this, though, because at the end of the day, like, tons of people hit me up and they're like, dude, I can't get on I2P. I can't get on I2P. So it's really awesome to have a like a kind of a solution where you can just kind of like download it and kind of go, you know. And then like we see right here, failed, you know, and it's like, oh, man, it failed. But so I saw like, you know, these proxy error, host not found. You may try to find a host on jump services below. So I was like, okay, let's see what this jump services is all about, you know? And we get this. What this is, I have not the faintest idea, but it says we're going to be redirected to a different destination. And it's like, you know, you still suck. So I'm like, all right, we're just going to hit continue. And it's crazy that like it didn't find it at first. And then we like have these kind of redirects that are like, oh no, we got you, you know, come this way. And boom, here we go. You know, W3 schools on I2P. So very cool stuff. Very cool stuff. And again, you guys saw I didn't configure anything. There was none of that, man. It's just, you know, load it up, you know, and you're good to go. And again, this is a live distro. So, you know, once we exit out of this, like everything's gone. And again, I want to confirm, like, I haven't read the code. I haven't like went through it in detail. The only thing I know is that this thing runs and, you know, we can set up I2P on it. Like it comes by default. I mean, you know, runs by default. And you see like here, I kind of have like this half and half kind of, you know, shot at it where like sometimes things work, sometimes they don't. And it's like, I wish there was some other way. I'm going to put this. So, you know, a big shout out to the, not only the subreddit for this OS and its creator who I mentioned before. But also, you know, a big shout out to the I2P community, the subreddit, on I2P. So r/I2P on subreddit. Awesome. Awesome dudes. I talked to them. They let me post my Tor versus I2P video up there. I have no clue what this website is. It was a random site that was on the I2P subreddit. So like I just grabbed it to look at it, see if it loaded. And it loaded and I didn't know what the hell it was. So I wasn't clicking anything else. but we can see it's kind of like a directory, right? So we can see like, you know, it says active and we're looking at 636 out of 6,668 I2P sites, apparently, which is pretty awesome, you know, we're going to go through these and really get into them and check them out. That would be pretty cool. But I seen like this Alpha Bay one and I was like, all right, yeah, let me plug this one in. And you know, it was just like, yeah, I'm not going to work for you. You know, I'm going to kick you in the teeth instead and make you look stupid in front of all the people who are going to watch this video. So, you know, basically though, you know, that was, that's the big thing. So now that I'm done, right, we're done. We're going to go here and we're going to, start Graceful shutdown. Don't exit out of the virtual machine, man. Like, don't just exit out, you know. Try to take care of the network a little bit. And from my understanding, that's what graceful shutdowns actually do. Like I said, I'm not a master at I2P. I'm a total novice, you know what I mean? Like I said, I'm learning with you guys. And it's like little evolutions like this that, like, I see that. I'm like, oh, man, I gotta share that, you know. So it was really exciting to see that there's an out-of-the-box solution for people to be able to get onto I2P now. And it's not like, oh, I'll configure this and do this. Like my 10 minute I2P video did very well, probably because people have a lot of trouble getting on I2P. So it's going to be awesome seeing this alleviate all of those things. You know, the no configuration, no, none of that crap. Like, you guys saw none of that crap, you know? So go load it up and, like, do me a favor. If you guys run this, run it and try to run it for at least an hour. Like, even if you don't do anything, just hop on and let it run. If you can let it run in the background, if you have the resources to do that, because it definitely helps out the network, you know? That's going to be all, guys. It was awesome. I really had a blast making this video. And again, shouts out to all those different subreddits right here. Definitely go visit them, become members, and catch updates and, you know, read about some of those things in real time. Don't forget to subscribe and like the video. It definitely helps. And I will see you guys in the next video.